Welcome to Day 7 of Warhammer TV's Advent Calendar. Now, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at a question which we suspected would be popular because people have been asking us how to do this for quite some time. Tim Wright is one of many people who wants to know how to paint Harlequin diamonds. Now, the truth of this is doing it is actually quite tricky because it requires freehanding, so it does require practice and patience. But there are some things that you can do to make it easier, so I'm going to show you in this video how I would approach doing it. Now, the way to do it is to first of all establish one of your colours, and we're going to be going for the colour scheme of the Mask of the Midnight Sorrow, which is the one with the red and blue diamonds you can see on the box. However, you can do any colour scheme you want to, just follow the same steps, but swap out the colours for the ones you want. But we're going to start out by establishing the blue, so for that we'll begin with a base coat of Calidor Sky, and then we'll layer all over it with Lothan Blue. After that, we need to mark in the actual pattern, and for this we'll use Abaddon Black, and once we're happy with it, we'll then paint in all the red diamonds using Mephiston Red. After that, all that remains is to highlight the pattern, so for the blue, we're going to use Baharoth Blue, and for the red, we'll use Evil Sun Scarlet. But starting out with our first colour, Calidor Sky, for our base paint, always remember to give your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and what I'm looking to do is to paint the entirety of the area where I want the diamond pattern to be with this colour. So I'm going to use my small base brush for this, and I'm going to make use of my palette here to thin my paint so it's under control and also will go onto the miniature nice and smoothly. So you're looking for about that kind of consistency. Make sure you don't have too much on your brush, and then you just got to decide where you want your pattern to be. Now you can see on my Harlequin here, I have already base coated some details just to help the pattern stand out a bit more. And generally the pattern is quartered across the miniature. So what I mean by that is it'll be down on this leg, and then the opposite quarter of the miniature will be up on this arm. So I'm going to be base coating all of these two areas, and you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour to build up to a nice strong finish. Once you're happy with the placement of where the patterns are going to go, the next thing to do is to apply a layer all over these blue areas of Lothan Blue to really build up to that nice bright blue that we want. Now, Lothan Blue is a layer paint, so it's a little bit transparent, so having Calidor Sky down first of all means you're going to get a much stronger and more vibrant colour. Now I'm going to be applying it this time using my medium layer brush, but the application really is identical to what we just did with Calidor Sky. So once you've got your paint thinned down to a nice smooth consistency, so about there like that, all you've got to do is apply this to the areas where the patterns are going to go, just to build up that colour. And as before, you will need to apply two thin coats to get to a good strong finish. I've finished applying the Lothan Blue, and with that we're now ready to start painting in the actual pattern, so this is where the difficult bit begins. We need Abaddon Black for this, and I really do recommend using an artificer brush because you really need as fine a tip on your brush as you can get. So what I'm going to do is use my palette to thin my paint down a bit more than I normally would, so it's flowing really smoothly. So just add enough water until you get into about that kind of consistency there. So you see it's quite inky really. And then just twist your brush to bring the bristles to a nice tip. And what I find really helps out with doing this is just to practice a bit on your palette. Just practice painting some thin straight lines, because this way you can just get the right kind of feel for the amount of pressure you need to put on your brush, and you can also get used to how thin the paint needs to be as well. Now I also find really it just helps warm up to the whole process, and once you've got your paint to the right kind of thickness and you're ready, what you've got to do is get your Harlequin, and well, I'm going to start on the leg because this is a nice straight area to show you how to do this. What you need to do is just begin with an initial line at about 30 degrees or so from vertical, so about there like that. Now this is tricky, so don't worry about any mistakes for the moment because we'll be coming back to fix it up. But this initial guideline needs to run all the way down the area, so basically it's going to spiral all the way down this Harlequin's leg. And once you're happy with this line, it then forms the basis for the pattern, because the other ones basically go either side of it. So leave as much space as you want for the size of your diamond, and then basically repeat this above and below. Now, the size of the diamond really does determine exactly how hard this is to do, so you can make them bigger if you want to, or smaller if you're feeling brave, but go for whatever's comfortable for just for you. I'm happy now with the placement of these lines, but you can see some of them are a little bit messy, but that's okay, because for the moment we're just marking in where the pattern's going to go. And with those lines done, we now need to do the same thing in, well, the opposite direction to actually form the full pattern of the diamond. So just repeat the exact same process of what you were doing, again being as neat as you can. I've finished applying all the black lines to the Harlequin's leg now, and I'm happy with the general placement, however they are of course a little bit messy. So what I need to do now is basically neaten them back up again. So I have both Lothan Blue and Abaddon Black at the ready, and I'm going to be jumping back and forth between these quite quickly as I need to. But I'm going to start with Lothan Blue, and I'm still using my artificer brush to do this. And as we did previously, just thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth, and then make sure you've not got very much on your brush so you're in control of what you're doing. And basically what you've got to do is now look to neaten up all the lines. So any parts where they've spurred off a little bit where it's where you don't want them, for example, just there, just need to be as neat as possible in painting over that area there. And if you go over any of the black, once you finish with the blue, just go back to a Baden black to neaten those parts up as well. And just, well, carry on with this until you're happy with the final placement. Now, once this is done, I'm going to move on to the next section, which will be the arm up there. And when we come back, we can start painting the red parts of the diamonds. I've finished neatening up the pattern now, and also I've painted it on the arm and the body as well. And I just want to quickly draw your attention up to that part, because you can see the orientation of the diamonds actually changes from running along the arm to going vertical again on the body. Now in these cases, just make sure the parts you can see match up, so that's just there. But you can actually use the details of the model to hide any inconsistencies in the pattern as you adjust to the new direction. So for example, the gold there hides some, and also the armpit of the miniature as well. Now once you're happy with your pattern, the next thing to do is to start colouring in the red parts of it. And I'm going to be using Mephiston Red for this. I'm going to stick to my Artificer brush so I've got lots of control as to where I'm painting this colour. And all you've got to do is thin your paint down so it's running nice and smooth and you have lots of control over it. So a bit more than that, I think. There we are, to about that. And really it's just a case of picking one diamond, colouring it in with this red, and then working out from there. So I'm going to start on the leg, and I think I'll just start on this diamond here. And what I'm going to do is just be as neat as possible in filling that in, and then from here I can work outwards across the rest of the pattern. Now I do recommend you do start with one and work your way out, because that way you ensure you're painting the correct diamonds. If you jump away, you see you can get the wrong one, then ruin the pattern. So work your way out and just really take your time with this stage. And there we go. By following those steps, the pattern is now set in, and all that we've got to do is, well, highlight it. And for this, we're going to be highlighting the blue parts using Baharoth Blue and the red parts using Evelson Scarlet. And the technique for both of these is exactly the same. I'm going to be using my Artificer brush first of all for Baharoth Blue, for the blue diamonds. And what I'm looking to do is to use my palette as usual to thin my paint down so it's flowing nice and smoothly, because we want, once again, lots of control over what we're doing here. So you're looking for about that kind of consistency. Make sure you've got a good tip on your brush. And then what you're looking to do is to paint a line of this following the top two edges of each blue diamond. So for example, if I start on one on the leg just here, what I'm looking to do is to paint a line just running down that side there. And exactly the same on the other side. And doing this will give it a really nice quilted appearance. And then do exactly the same thing on all the red diamonds using Evelson Scarlet. And once you've done this, the diamonds will be complete. And there it is, the diamond pattern is complete, and you can see with that highlight, it's just given it a very nice, slightly three-dimensional effect and makes it look great. Now, the things to remember about doing this pattern is that, well, to be honest, it's actually quite difficult. So it does require patience and practice to get it right, but keep at it because you will master it eventually. And when you do, you'll have mastered one of the most difficult color schemes in Warhammer 40,000. Now, it really helps to do this scheme if you thin your paints down correctly, particularly with a Baden black when you're marking in your pattern. If the paint's at the correct consistency, it'll apply smoothly to the miniature and will help you control exactly where the pattern's going to go. Finally, remember when you are marking in that pattern, have that time to go back and forth just to make sure that you've laid it out correctly and to a point that you're happy with. If you do make any mistakes, you can go back over it before you start to fill in the rest of the colour. Now, we really hope that you've enjoyed this video and found it useful to learn exactly how to do this. So have fun painting your Harlequins and, of course, showing off the pattern to your friends as well. We'll see you again soon. If you enjoyed that tutorial and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to our YouTube channel, Warhammer TV, which is full of loads of other tutorials, but also trailers and miniature showcases too.
If you want to watch some right now, why not check out some of the videos down below?